Motivation Orange.
Raise your hand if you agree that saving money is one of the most painful things to do in the world. You have to be watching every penny spent. That means no entertainment, no outings, and sometimes even not spending an extra dollar on food. What a lot of sacrifices you have to make. How fun can life be this way? Question is there a better way? Let us tell you. Yes. If cutting your spending significantly is your main saving strategy, we won't be surprised if you've attempted to start a saving plan several times and given up before long. This is especially true if you had planned to do so in the long run. Worse, along the way you might have suppressed many little joys in life in a cold-blooded manner. It is possible that once you pass the threshold of your tolerance, you ended up spending most of the money you have saved, or even all of it. And the cycle of saving money, spending it all, saving again, and spending it all continues. And you are just wasting time achieving nothing. You see, if saving is all about reducing the quality of life and suppressing joy, will ordinary folks like you and us, who were not born with superhuman determination, be able to persist? The good news is, there is a wiser saving strategy out there. Instead of eliminating almost all expenses, this strategy makes you manage your money in a practical way. It allows you to cover your daily expenses, spend on things that you enjoy, and save a portion of your income, all at the same time. Sounds impossible? Wait till we show you this brilliant strategy. Before we reveal it to you, here are two things you should know. First, we are not trying to provide professional financial advice here. Well, we are not trained to do so, nor pretending that we are. Just sharing an idea we found useful. Feel free to evaluate if it fits your situation. As always, seek help from your financial advisor or accountant when you need it. Second, the strategy we're talking about is still a saving plan, meaning that you still have to have a budget and watch your spending. The difference is, the process becomes less painful, more practical, and it's likely that you won't hate what you're doing. You'll have a higher success rate in saving money too. Introducing to you, the 6-Jar Money Management System created by T. Harv Eker, the author of a New York Times bestseller, Secrets of the Millionaire Mind. What's unique about this method is, it approaches saving money in a more human manner. It doesn't ask you to skimp on every penny. Instead, it provides a practical plan on how you manage your spending. You will see, you can still enjoy life while keeping a portion of your money. Why are you more likely to succeed with this approach? Let us explain with an analogy. Emily and Sarah were two young women. They were pretty much alike, both in their late 20s, working office jobs, and leading a typical city dweller's lifestyle. Unfortunately, the problems they faced were similar too. Among that, they felt they needed to lose some weight after neglecting their exercise routine and eating habits for too long. They both did what were necessary. They set targets, signed up for the same gym class, and changed their lifestyle to a healthier one. But there was one difference. Emily adopted an aggressive diet. She cut her food intake to half, eating way below her means. She felt hungry all the time, happily so though. She thought, hungry is good. Hunger is my best friend in losing weight. Sarah, on the other hand, didn't follow the same path. Instead, she ate about the same amount of food, but watched what she ate closely. She replaced high-carb food with lighter food, meat with more vegetables. A more balanced meal, she called it. 6 months later, Sarah hit her weight loss target. And Emily? No progress. In fact, she gave up after starving herself for 2 months. We guess you can see why Sarah succeeded but Emily didn't. Emily adopted a diet plan that was not sustainable as it demanded too much of her. But Sarah had chosen a more practical one. Do you see how this is related to your saving strategy? If all you do is obsessively cutting down your spending, it is likely that your saving plan will not sustain for long, as it is taking away too much from you and causing you too much pain in the process. You want a system that you can adopt for the long run. A reasonable plan that you can execute in a healthy and balanced manner. Think about Sarah's diet plan. The 6-Jar Money Management System fits these criteria. How does the system work? The idea is to divide your income into the following 6 groups. Necessities. Long-term saving. Education. Financial freedom. Play. And giving back. We will explain what each of these is. Oh, by the way, when we say jars, we don't really mean glass containers that you store cookies in. They are bank accounts or other ways you keep your money. Just to be clear. So the first jar is necessities. It's recommended that you put 55% of your total income into this jar. The money in this jar covers your expenses on food, transport, rent or mortgage, water and electricity bills, and so on. Some might complain that 55% is not enough to cover all their expenses. Although T. Harv Eker did say that 55% is not a hard and fast rule, he strongly encourages us to review our spendings and live within our means. The second jar is long-term savings. You want to save 10% of your income into this jar as the rainy day fund, to afford incoming big purchases, to prepare for medical expenses, and so on. As the name suggests, this is where you save money to prepare for your future or for long-term uses. Your retirement fund goes into this jar too. The third jar is your financial freedom account. You want to allocate 10% of your income into this jar for the purpose of accumulating wealth. The money can be used in stocks, properties, building passive incomes, and other investments. You want to leave the money here alone and not spend it under any circumstances until you become financially free. Besides investing to grow wealth, you should also invest in yourself. This is what the money in your fourth jar, education, is to be spent on. Allocate 10% of your income on your personal growth. This includes attending classes or seminars, buying new books, and getting mentors or coaches. 10% might seem a lot, but it's always worth it to increase your competency, or even to learn something new just for fun. Next, the play jar is the most interesting jar. Remember, we told you you don't have to completely remove the joy of life while you save. This is the jar for that. Every month, take out 10% of your income to spend on leisure and entertainment. You have worked hard, and you certainly deserve to spoil yourself and your loved ones with the fruit of your labor. Go to an expensive dinner, a movie, a massage, a weekend trip, whatever. You can do anything you like with the money in this jar. As long as you stay within the budget, you can even spend the last cent in this jar and not feeling guilty. This play jar is what differentiates the six-jar money management system from conventional saving strategies. Having taken care of other essential aspects of your finances, this system did not forget to include some fun and joy in life for you, simply because its creator understands that all work and no play will make you quit your game early. Brilliant, isn't it? Last but not least, it is always good to contribute some money back to society. The money in the sixth jar is exactly for this purpose. It's recommended that you allocate 5% of your income to the giving back jar and donate it to your chosen charities or causes, or to help those in need. To recap, when you follow the six-jar money management system, you will divide your income into six groups according to the suggested percentages. Jar 1. Necessities, 55%. This is for your daily expenses. Jar 2. Long-term savings. You save 10% of your income for your future. Jar 3. Financial freedom account, 10%. You invest money in this jar to accumulate wealth. Jar 4. Education. 10% of your income will be invested in your personal growth. Jar 5. The exciting play jar, 10%. Here is the money you spend on leisure. And lastly, jar 6. Giving back. 5% of your income will be donated for some good karma. Check again, and you will see this is a robust plan that covers every aspect of your spending, allows you to save a healthy portion of your income, encourages you to accumulate wealth, and does not require you to completely sacrifice the quality of your life. Yes, all these in an easy-to-follow plan. You will find no problem to do this for 1 year, 3 years, 5 years, 10 years, or even until you retire. The beauty of this method is, no matter what your current income level is, be it $1,000 or $10,000, you can adopt this system. Even kids can follow it too, to learn a proper way to manage their pocket money. Good habits must start early. Lastly, there's another advantage of this system that most miss out on. Did you see how it can motivate you to earn more money? Earlier, we told you that you can freely spend the money in your play jar however you want, whenever you want, on whatever you want. What do you do if you feel like having more money to buy happiness? No, you don't increase the percentage you allocate to the play jar. Instead, you need to figure out how to make more money and work hard toward increasing your overall income so that you can put more money into the play jar. Similarly, when you have a big purchase plan like getting a car or a house, you want to work out a plan to improve your earning, but not try to change the percentage allocated to the long-term saving jar. This is how you get motivated to earn more money. The six-jar money management system is a completely doable system that you can start implementing now. At the end of this video, we invite you to try out this system. As the first step, get a piece of paper, do the math, and work out how much you should put into each of your jars according to the recommended percentages. When your next paycheck arrives, try implementing the six-jar money management system for at least 1 month. By the end of the month, you will see how your money habits and your attitude toward money will have changed. Take the first step now. We are confident that you want to continue doing this for many years to come. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, don't forget to give us a like or thumb up, and feel free to share it. Subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. See you in the next video.